Hello students, good morning. This is mathematics standard 5. The chapter is LCM and HCF. This is the third chapter. Today we learn problems based on HCF and LCM. We will do the problems based on HCF and LCM. You see the first example. Find the smallest number of 5 digits, which when divided by 60, 90 and 80, leaves no remainder. The second question is, the remainder is 5 in every case. This is the question. The first question is, there is no remainder when the smallest 5 digit number, which is divided by 60, 90 and 80, there is no remainder. The smallest number which can be divided by each of the given numbers with no remainder is LCM of the given numbers. So we find the LCM 60, 90 and 80. We take 2. 32 is 45, 2 is 90, 42 is 80, then again 2, 15, 2 is 30, 45 is not divisible by 2, so carry forward, 2, 20 is 40, again we will take 3, 3, 5 is 15, 3, 15 is 45, then 20, 20 is not divisible by 20 is not divisible by 3, so we will write 20 same. We will write 20. Then we will take 4, 5, 5 1 ja, 5 3 ja, 5 4 ja. So the LCM is 2 into 2 into 3 into 5 into 1 into 3 into 4, that equal to 720 is the LCM. So we have to find the smallest number of 5 digits which divided by 60, 90 and 80 leaves. But we find the number with the smallest number which is divisible by 60, 90 and 80. But we want the 5 digits number. So you see 720 is the smallest number that can be divisible by 60, 90 and 80 with no remainder. We have to find the smallest multiple of 720 which is of 5 digits. Okay, so let the smallest 5 number digit is 10,000. We divide 10,000 by 720. The quotient is 13 and the remainder is 640. If we subtract 640, the remaining number will not 5 digit. So what we will do? 13th multiple of 720 is less than 10,000, but the 14th multiple will be more than 10,000. The smallest 5 digit number is divisible by 720. So the 14th multiple is 720 into multiplied by 14, that is 10,080 is the answer. That is the number 5 digit smallest number is 10,080, which is divisible divided by 60, 90 and 80. There is no remainder. Okay. Next, second bit, you see the common remainder is 5. So the required number can be also found as 10,000 minus 640. This is the first question. The second bit is the required number is 10,080 plus the common remainder in all cases, that equal to 10,080 plus 5, that is 10,085. If we will divide 10,085 by 60, 90 or 80, the remainder should be 5. Okay, did you understood? You see the next problem. Okay, the question is, find the greatest number of 3 digits which when divided by 75, 45 and 60 leaves no remainder. In second bit, the remainder is 5 in each case. Just like before, before the example, the number we required is 5 digit number, but this is 3 digit number. First we take the LCM. Okay, we take the LCM of which numbers? 75, 45 and 60. We take 3, 25, 3 is 75, 15, 3 is 45, 23 is 60. Then again 5 by 5, 5, 5 is 25, 5, 3 is 15, 5, 4 is 20. So the LCM equal to 3 into 5 into 5 into 3 into 4 is 900. But we want the largest 3 number, so 999 divided by 900 equal to 900, 900, remainder is 99. So we subtract this remainder to divisibility. Okay, the greatest 3 digit number exactly divisible by 75, 45 and 60 is 999 minus 99 is 900. And the required number where the remainder is 5, that is 905. Okay. Now, we will do some more word problems. You see the example, find the greatest number that will divide 37, 56 and 93, leaving the remainder 1, 2 and 3 respectively. So, we have to get remainder 1, 2, 3 respectively. We first subtract these numbers from respective numbers, that is 37 minus 1, that is 36. 56 minus 2, that is 54, and 93 minus 3 is 90. Okay, 36, we will do these problems by long division method. Okay, here is given long division. These numbers are 36, 54 and 90. So, we divide first these two numbers, 54 by 36. 36, 1 is 36, remainder is 8, 8, 2 is 36. So, HCF of 36, 54 is 18. Then, find the HCF of 18 and the last number 90. 18, 5 is 90. It is divisible when the remainder is 0. The divisor is the HCF. That means HCF equal to HCF of 37, 56 and 93 equal to 18. Okay. Then what we will do? Therefore, the required number is 18. That means the 18 is the greatest number that will divide 37, 56 and 93. The remainders respectively 1, 2 and 3. So, the answer is 18. Okay. You see another example, 4 bells ring together at 2 p.m. 4 bells ring together at a time, at 2 p.m. If the bells ring in interval of 2, 5, 8 and 10 minutes respectively, That means first bell after ringing the first bell, after 2 minutes the second will ring. After 5 minutes the third will. Like this, at 4 bells rang together. If the bells ring in interval of, not like this, first bell ring after each 2 minutes, second will ring after each 5 minutes, third bell will ring after each 8 minutes, okay, like fourth bell will ring after 10 minutes, respectively. It will, at what time will they ring together next? When the next time ring, at all at a time. Okay, so we have to find the LCM of 2, 5, 8 and 10. 2, 5, 8 and 10. The LCM equal to, divide by 2, 2 1s are 2, 5, 5 is not divisible by 2, so we carry forward. 2 4 ja 8, 2 5 ja 10. Then again we take 5, 5 1 ja, here also 5, 1 ja 1 is not divisible, so we carry 1, 5 1 ja 5, 4 is also not divisible, so we will write 4, 5 1 ja 5. So the LCM equal to 2 into 5 into 1 into 1 into 4 into 1 equal to 40. That means after 40 minutes, the bells are rang at a time. So, all the bells will again ring together after 40 minutes. The bell will ring together again 2 plus 40 minutes, that is 2:40 p.m. at 2:40 p.m. Okay, now we will do the problems given, word problems. You see the first question, find the smallest number which when added by 5 is divisible by 12, 14 and 18. What are the numbers? 12, 14 and 18. When we add 5, then it is divisible by 12, 14 and 18. So, first we find the LCM, then subtract 5 from the LCM. That is the answer. We take 2, 6, 2, 7, 2, 9. Again, 3, 2, 7 is not divisible by 3. So, we carry forward. 3, 3 ja. Therefore, LCM equal to 2 into 3 into 2 into 7 into 3. That equal to 2, 3 ja, 6, 2 ja, 12, 12, 7 ja, 84, 84, 3 ja, 84, 3 ja, 252. So, the required answer is, therefore, required answer is 252 minus 5, that equal to 247. So, what we will write? The smallest number 247 is the smallest number when added by 5, when added by 5 is divisible by 12, 14 and 18. So when we will add 256 by 5, the number is divisible by 12, 14 and 18. Okay, you see the next question. A heap is to be formed with lots of 8, 10 and 15 pebbles of different colors. Find the smallest number of pebbles in the heap. You see, I am again reading the question. A heap is to be formed with lots of 8, 10 and 15 pebbles of different colors. Find the smallest number of pebbles in the heap. Okay. You see, what type of heaps, what type of pebbles? Size is 8, 10 and 15. So, the smallest number of pebbles is the LCM of 8, 10 and 15. Okay, we find the LCM. 2 divisible by these two numbers, 2 4 ja, 2 5 ja, 15 is not divisible. So, we carry forward. Again, these two numbers divisible by 5, we will write 4, 5 1 ja, 5 3 ja. Therefore, LCM equal to 2 into 5 into 4 into 1 into 3. That equal to 10 for the 40, 43 the 120. 120. So, 120 is the smallest number of pebbles in the heap. 120 is the smallest number. 120 is the smallest number of pebbles in the heap. 120 is the smallest number of pebble in the heap. Okay, next question, you see question number 3. Now we'll do. You see the question number 3. 3 measuring tapes. There are 3 measuring tapes of 64 cm, 72 cm and 96 cm. What is the shortest length that can be measured by any one of these tapes exactly? Sir, we find the shortest length by which, by these 3 tapes can be measured that length. So, we will find the, what the length of the tapes are, 64 and 72 and 92 centimeters. So, to find out the shortest length, we find the LCM of these numbers. So, we will take 72 divisible divided by 2, 36, this is 48, this is the 96, so 48. Then again, you take 2, 16 ja, 18 ja, 24 ja, again take 2, 8 ja, 2, 9 ja, 2, 12 ja. Now, 8 and 12 are divisible by 2, so 2 4 ja, 9 remain same, 2 6 ja, again 2 2 ja, 9 2 3 ja, then 3. So the LCM is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 3, 6. How many 2s are there? 3 into 3 into 1. You may write or not, because the answer is same. So, 2 to the power 6 equal to 2 to the 4. 2 into 2 into 2, that is 64, into 9, that is equal to 576. So the length, shortest length, length is equal to 576 centimeter, that can be exactly. Measure by 60 centimeter, 64 centimeter, 72 centimeter and 96 centimeter steps. Okay. Did you understood? Now we will do the, now question number 4. Find the greatest number that will exactly divide 73 and 170. We have to find the greatest number. That means the greatest number is HCF of these two numbers. We have to find the HCF 73 and 117. These two numbers are prime numbers, they will not divide any other number. So answer is 1. Here 73 117. So 1 is the greatest number that will exactly divide, that will exactly divide, that will exactly divide, divide 73 and 117. Okay, did you understood? The HCF of these two numbers is the answer. Okay. You see, question number 5 is two ropes of length 28 meter and 36 meter are to be cut into beads of same length. Find the greatest possible length for each bead. You see, the length of the ropes is, one is 28 meter and the next is 36 meter. We cut these ropes into beads, but I'll find the greatest possible length for each bead. Okay, the 28 meter rope will be cut into beads and this one also cut into beads. We have to find the largest number length which can be, the rope will be cut, both the ropes. Okay, we first divide, take the HCF of these two numbers, 28 and 36. Two, both are divided, divisible by 2, 14, here is 18, then we will take 2, 7, 9, then HCF equal to 2 into 2 equal to 4. So 4 meter length is the highest length, the greatest possible length. So therefore the greatest possible length equal to 4 meter. So we have to cut, the length of the beads is 4 meter. Okay, again I am telling, see, we cut into beads of the length of rope is 28 and 36 meter. find the greatest possible length for each bit. For each bit, the greatest length is 4 meter, by which these two lengthy ropes are cut into bits. Okay. You see, question number 6, find the largest size of handkerchiefs which can be cut from a cloth having length, one of the cotton piece is 2.75 meter and breadth is 75 centimeter. Of largest size, we have to find the largest size of handkerchief which can be cut from the cloth. The size of the cloth is length, whose length is 2.75 and breadth is 75 centimeter. So both we will take in centimeter, that is 275 centimeter, and this is 75 centimeter. We will find the HCF of these numbers. You see, these numbers is divisible by 5. 5 5 ja 25 5 5 ja 25 5 1 ja 5 remain 2 5 ja 25. Again we will take 5, 11 ja 5, 3 ja. So HCF equal to 5 into 5 equal to 25. HCF of the these two numbers is 25. So the answer is 25. Each length and breadth, length equal to 25 and breadth equal to also 25 of the handkerchief. So the answer is the size of the handkerchief, the size of the largest size of the handkerchief is 25 into 25, that is length 25, breadth also 25 in size. Okay. Question number 7. What is the capacity of the largest vessel which can empty the oil from 3 vessels containing 32 liters, 24 liters and 48 liters an exact number of times? Okay. What is the capacity of 3 containers? One is 32 liters, next is 24 liter and another is 48 liter. We have to find a container by which these 3 containers should be vacant with an exact number. Okay, so we have to find the HCF, that is 32, 24 and 48. All are divisible by 2, 16, 12, 24. Again, we will take 2, 8 ja, 2, 6 ja, 48, 12. Okay. Again, we will take 2, 2, 4 ja, 2, 3 ja, 2, 6 ja. Now, all the numbers are not multiples of any common prime number. So HCF is 2 into 2 into 2 equal to 8. So the capacity of the vessel is 8 liter. By 8 liter vessel, we can empty these containers of 32, 24 and 80 liters. So we will write the capacity of the largest vessel, the p capacity of the largest vessel equal is 8 liter. Okay, the capacity of the largest vessel is 8 liter. Okay, next we will do the next. You see the question number 8. Okay, question number 8 is find the smallest number of 4 digit which when divided by 6, 8, 12 and 20 leaves no remainder. First is leaves no remainder, and the second bit is the remainder 7 in each case. We will first the do the first bit. The numbers are 6, 8, 12 and 20. First we will find the number by which 6, 8, 12 and 20 all are divisible by the number. The number is divisible by these four numbers. Okay. First we will take its LCM 6, 8, 12, 20. The LCM 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 6, 2, 10. Again, we will take 2, 3, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 5. Then we will take 3. These two numbers are divisible by 3. 3, 1, 5. Therefore, LCM equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 1 into 2 into 1 into 5. That equal to 5 to the 10, 3 to 30, 2 to 60, 2 to 120 is the LCM. So, we have to find the 3-digit number. We have to find the 4-digit number. So, we will take the smallest 4-digit number and divide by 120. 12, 8, 96, so 60 remainder is 40. So, 120 into 9 is the, if we will take 960, this is not a 4 digit number. So, we will take 129, that is 1080. We will write 1080 is the smallest 4 digit number divided divided by 6, 8, 12 and 20 without any remainder. Okay, again in the second bit, in each case 7 is the remainder. So, the number is 1080 plus 7. That is 1087 is the answer. When we divided 1087 by 6, 8, 12 and 20, in each case remainder should be 7. Okay. You see the question number 9, find the greatest number that will be divided 39, 52, 135, leaving remainder 3, 4, 5 respectively. That means when from 39, the remainder is 3, 52 remainder is 4 and 125 remainder is 5. So this is equal to 36, 48 and 120. We first take these numbers, then we find the HCF. Okay, 36, 48, 120. The number should be divisible by 12. Okay, 12 3 ja, 12 4 ja, 12 10 ja. Any other number that is no number divisible by these three numbers. So 12 is the number. So we will write 12 is the number that will divide. 12 divide which number? 39, 52 and 125, leaving reminder 3, 4 and 5 respectively. That means when we divide 39, 52 and 125 by 12, in first case the remainder is 3, in 52 remainder must be 4 and 125 remainder should be 5. Okay, 12 is the answer. You see the question number 10. Question number 10 is, three bells ring together. If the bells ring at intervals of 10, 15 and 20 seconds respectively. First bell rings at a 10 seconds, after 10 seconds, second in 15 seconds, 20 seconds is third. After what interval of time will they ring together again? So we have to find out the LCM of these numbers. The LCM should be the answer. After that time they will ring together. What is the numbers? 10, 15 and 20. So these numbers take 2, 5 ja, 15, 10. Again we will take 5, 1 ja, 5, 3 ja, 5, 2 ja. LCM equal to 2 into 5 into 1 into 3 into 2, that equal to 60 second. After 60 second, the rings will ring together. After an interval of 60 second, the bells ring together again. Okay, you write here, after 60 second of interval, the bells ring together again. Okay, this chapter is finished. Next period, we will do the fourth chapter, fraction. Okay.